I am Brother Stephen Elabo, welcoming you to Deeper Life Bible Church, Charlottesville, United States, a place where the undiluted Word of God is being preached. You are about to listen to our General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, as he comes forth to share the mind of God with you and your family. I want you to be ready. Pick up your pen and your paper and jot down important messages as they will do you good. God bless you and remain blessed.
The word of God upon your life tonight. You lost an amen over there. I'm looking at Hebrews chapter 11. And I'm reading to you from verse 4. You know, when you look at Hebrews chapter 11, and as you open it from verse 1, it says, now faith. That's what now. That tells us at this time, on this day, and for you over there, faith is going to work in your life. There are some things that come and go. There are some things you saw last time. You don't see them today. There are some things old people spoke about. And young people don't speak about you today. There are some things old men spoke about. The patriarchs of old. The people of old. The prophets of old. And the people that had problems in the past. There were things they spoke about. They don't talk about them anymore. But there's something peculiar about faith. It was at that time. And it is at this time. And it will be there tomorrow. That's why it says now faith. And then it says faith is. It is not was. It used to be, and it is no more. It says now faith. And today, faith will come in your heart. Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And when that faith arrives, somebody there, that faith will arise. Somebody there, that faith will come. And somebody there, the faith will pierce your life. It will come in your soul. It will come in your mind. It will come in your spirit. And when that faith arrives, something you never saw before, something you never experienced before, it will happen tonight. Somebody there said it will happen tonight. Because faith is, it is the substance of things hoped for. And it is the evidence of things not seen. And it's the faith I'm talking about tonight. Come to verse 4 now. By faith, Abel. By faith, Abel. You're selling us whatever Abel became. And whatever you are going to become, it's going to be by faith. Not by unbelief. Not by doubt. Not by crime. Not by rolling on the ground. By faith, Abel. And by you tonight, Abel, you are going to have faith. You will not be like and that faith will work in a dynamic way in your life. And then it goes on and on. And it comes to verse 39. And it says, all these having obtained a good report through faith. It's coming from the very beginning. And he talks about faith. And it comes to the very end. And it says everyone and anyone,
the
problems are going to be solved. If the power is going to come, if the sickness is going to be healed, if miracle is going to come, if salvation is going to come to your soul, if you're going to receive the blessing of heaven, it begins by faith. It goes on by faith. And it ends by faith. I want to talk to you tonight. And after the talk, we will pray. I will pray. You will pray. We will pray. When my prayer, your prayer, when they come together, there will be an explosion of miracle. I'm talking on the wonders of faith. The wonders of faith. You know, if you're looking for signs and wonders, it's based on faith. If you're looking for the supernatural, it's based on faith. If we're looking for problems to be solved, it's based on faith. If you're waiting for salvation, it's based on faith. If you're waiting for the supernatural encounter, it's based on faith. If you're waiting for the broom of heaven to come and sweep away all the cobweb of the devil in your life, in your family, it's by faith. And it says, by faith, Abel. As we talk about faith in Christ. As we talk about faith in the blood of the Lamb. As we talk about faith in the name of Jesus. The name above every name. The name above your cancer. The name above your tuberculosis. The name above your deafness. The name above your paralysis. The name above the yoke in your life. The name above the problem in your life. Every curse is canceled tonight from your life. In the name of Jesus, the name that works wonders, the name that saves, the name that heals, and the faith that delivers, and the faith that sets you free, faith in Christ, faith in his blood, faith in his name. We look up to him. You see, Christ is central. Look up here. And you look at Christ standing here. Those who are on this side, they're looking towards Christ. And those who are on this side, they're looking directly at Christ. And those who are on this side, they're looking in this direction with Christ. What does that mean? What it means is this: Christ came. Before he came, the people who were over here, like Abraham, like Sarah, like Joseph, like Caleb, like Joshua, they were looking at this side, looking at the Christ who is to come. How did they know he was coming? Because God said, the seed of the woman, referring to Christ, will bruise the head of the devil. And so, over here, from generation, unto us a child is born. unto us a son is given. The government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. He will be called Emmanuel. That's all these people here looking up to him here. And then he came. He was born in Bethlehem. He came. He was raised in Nazareth. He came. He went throughout Galilee. He came. And he went to Capernaum. And the people that were living at the time when he came, they were looking at him directly. Those people over there, before Christ came, expectation. They were expecting. And they were looking at him afar off. At the time when he came, they saw him face to face. They touched him. He touched them. He opened their blind eyes. He raised the dead. He healed the sick. He forgave their sins. Experience. Those other people here, before Christ came, they looked up to him in expectation. The people that lived at the time he came, they had experience. He died. He was buried. He rose again. He went to heaven. Before he went to heaven, he says, I give my name unto you. Now whatsoever you ask in that name, and you ask the Father, he will do it for you. Now he is gone. We are the people on this side. We turn around and we're looking at him now. What do we look for? Remember, the people who were on this side yesterday, expectation. The people who were directly when he came to the world today, that's experience. And the people that on the side were living after he has died, and were living after he was buried, were living after he rose from the dead, were living after he went to heaven, we live on his name. We live on his power. We live on his authority. But we're looking from this side and looking at him because he died 2,000 years ago. Exploits. Exploits. Now we're going to have exploits today. Expectation from that side. Experience from this side. Exploits from the other side. That's why the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 13 verse 8. Jesus Christ the same. Yesterday. Those people, today, these people, and tomorrow is forever the same. And what you did before is going to be your life today. You are in for a miracle. There's no way you can escape miracles tonight. Miracle coming your way. Miracle coming to your side. Because we're talking about the wonders of faith. The wonders of faith from Abel to Zacchaeus. The wonders of faith from Abel, that's A, to Zacchaeus, that's Z. From the very beginning to the very end. And here you, well, whoever you are tonight, I shall hear the word of God. And faith comes at your life. Congratulations, a miracle is coming your way. Number one, I'm going to divide the message to three parts. Number one, the redemptive faith of Abel. The redemptive faith of Abel. Number two, the restorative faith of all others. The restorative faith of all others. You are there. Restoration has come. You are there. The peace of God has come. Whatever you have lost, and you are wondering, look at my life. Look at the sorrow. Look at the problem. Joy has come. I said, joy has come. Where's the person I'm talking about there? You will rejoice tonight. The restorative face of all others. Number three, the regenerative face of Zacchaeus. From Abel to Zacchaeus. Number one, we're looking at the redemptive face of Abel. I'm reading to you once again from Hebrews chapter 11. And I'm reading from verse 4. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain. By which he obtained witness that he was righteous. God testifying of his gifts, and by it he being dead, yet speaketh. Now you remember Adam and Eve. You remember God created them. Adam did not have a father or a mother, as lay here. Eve did not have father, mother on the earth over here. They were not born like you were born. They didn't arrive into the world like you arrived in the world. But all the other people that came into the world, everybody that arrived in the world was born of a woman. Cain was born of a woman. Abel was born of a woman. There is something peculiar about anybody that is born of a woman.
Abel,
Cain, yourself, myself, everybody in the world, the white,
the black, the brown,
Africans, Asians, Americans,
America, Asia,
everybody, except Adam and Eve. What's the peculiarity of anyone that is born of a woman? We're looking at Psalm 51. As you look at Psalm 51, I'm reading at verse 5. Psalm 51, verse 5. And you see the peculiarity. It says in this Psalm 51, verse 5, behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. You think of Abel, you think about yourself. I was shapen in iniquity. Adam and Eve had fallen. Adam and Eve had sinned. Adam and Eve had disobeyed God. Adam and Eve came out of the Garden of Eden. Adam and Eve were excommunicated out of the Garden of Eden. It was in exile, outside the garden, that Cain was born, that Abel was born, outside the Garden of
Eden.
That's where you were born. And because of that peculiarity, it says, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me.
It's
Psalm 58, verse 3. Psalm 58, verse 3. The wicked are estranged from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born. Speaking lies. He's telling us that when you arrive in this world, and when Abel arrived in this world, he arrived with something in the heart. He arrived with sin in the heart. Have you noticed that little girl? Have you noticed that little boy? Nobody teaches anybody how to tell a lie. Nobody teaches how to pretend. Nobody teaches how to be hypocritical. There is no course of studies for disobedience. They go astray as soon as they are born. As soon as Abel was born, as soon as you were born, you went astray. And you said he came from the womb. And you were telling lies. Look at Isaiah chapter 48. I'm reading here from verse 8. Isaiah chapter 48, verse 8. Yea, thou hadest not, yea, thou knewest not, yea, from the time that thine ears was not open, for I knew that thou wouldest deal very treacherously, and was called a transgressor from the womb.
Lóòótọ́ ìwọ kò gbọ́, lóòótọ́ ìwọ kò mọ̀, lóòótọ́ láti ìgbà náà etí rẹ kò sí, nítorí tí èmi mọ̀ pé ìwọ hùwà rekereke gidigidi.
From the womb, he was called a transgressor.
Listen,
nobody can say, this is how I am. I am all right. You are not all right. From the womb, you were a liar. From the womb, you were a sinner. You were born in sin. You were born in evil. And it says, your name was transgressor from the womb. That's what happened to Abel. And Abel began to realize, I need something because I feel guilty. I feel condemned. Since I was born, there is something in me that is going the wrong direction. And because of that, something must happen. In his own strength, he couldn't do it. In your own strength, you cannot do it. Religion cannot do it. Five self-discipline cannot do it. Going to drink River Jordan cannot do it. And going to Jerusalem cannot do it. And going to a particular denomination cannot do it. And burning candle cannot do it. And burning incense cannot do it. And giving money to the beggars cannot do it. But my tears forever flow, and my zeal no respite know. All this for sin cannot atone. Thou and thou alone must save. He needed redemption. All that he tried, he couldn't make it because nobody can make it. Everybody is guilty. Everybody is condemned. Anyone that is born of a woman arrived into this world in sin. Look at Job chapter 14.
Job
chapter 14. I'm reading from verse 4. Job chapter 14, verse 4. Who can bring a clean sin out of an unclean? Not one. Adam had sin.
Adam
he was unclean. Eve had sin. She was unclean. Uncleanness met with uncleanness. The guilty man met with the guilty woman. The sinful man met with the sinful woman. And there came Cain. And there came Abel. Who can bring a clean sin out of an unclean? Not one. Abel felt the guilt.
Abel
felt the condemnation. He felt the cleanness.
Oh my mare.
He said, what can wash my sin away? What can take my guilt away? What can take my condemnation away? If this condemnation remains there, where will I spend eternity? That's when he remembered what he had heard. Faith cometh by hearing by the word of God, that God had killed an animal, waiting for the time when the great lamp of God will come, and God had closed them with the skin of the animal. That's why he brought the sacrifice. He said, this will be my sacrifice. This will be my sin bearer. See, this will be my substitute. This will be my savior. Savior from the guilt. Savior from the condemnation. He was looking forward. Expectation. He was looking forward to the time when the seed of the woman shall come, and he will bruise the head of the devil. Today Jesus has come for you. Somebody there said, Jesus has come for you. You
were
born of a woman. Am I right? I said you were born of a woman. Are you born of an angel? Anybody there? Born of a woman. Are you there?
So what
are you? That's why you are a sinner. That's why you are a liar. That's why you are a transgressor. It's the nature. It's the heart. It's what you came to the world with. But thank God Jesus has come. Thank God Savior has come. Thank God Redeemer has come. Thank God your sacrifice has come. Thank God your sin bearer has come. Thank God your substitute has come. Tonight, the door of salvation is open to you. That's why I said, I am the way. I am the truth. I am the light. Anybody coming to the Father, they will come by me. He says, I am the door. And the door is open tonight. The door of mercy is open to you tonight. And the door of salvation is open to you tonight. And the door of the salvation redemption of the Lord is open to you tonight. And so he offered that sacrifice. He was looking forward. There was somebody. He was right at that time. Yesterday, that's
Abel.
Today, look at the man on the cross. Just today, this one is not yesterday. This one is not tomorrow. Today, he was dying on the cross. He felt guilty. He felt condemned. I will die. If I die today, where will I be? The sin I've been carrying since I was born. I've been a transgressor since I was born. And here I'm going to die today. All of a sudden, look at Jesus. Look at Jesus. He's dying for you. It's a sacrifice. It's a substitute. It's a sin bearer. He is your Savior. He looked at him. Not like Abel looking from afar. Not like Abel looking from yesterday. Today. And so he prayed. God will answer your prayer today. Somebody there said, God will answer your prayer today.
He said,
Lord.
He
called him Lord. He called him Savior. He called him Master. He said, you are my King. He said, are my Lord. He said, Lord, remember me when you get your kingdom. And Jesus said, the first word he mentioned, he said, today, everybody shouts today.
Today,
thou shalt be with me in paradise. He got an experience. Yesterday, Abel was looking up to the seed of the woman to come. And he was with expectation. And the Lord made him righteous. And the Lord forgave him. The thief from the cross. Today, you will be with me in paradise.
He had
an experience. Here we are today.
We
are not on the cross now to die. But I've told you this story. You read the story yourself. And it's about Jesus that came. About Jesus that died. And we're looking at him from this place now to the other side. You know the other people. People, they live in B.C. That is before Christ, B.C. And when we write their date, they say, we write the date and say B.C. They were looking this direction with expectation. And today, when we write our date, it's now A.D. It's Latin, but the English meaning is after his death. And after he has died for us, now we're AD. And we're looking this direction. I look and I see Jesus tonight. Somebody there, I look, I see Jesus tonight. Somebody there, I look, I see your Savior tonight. Somebody there, I look and see your Redeemer tonight. Somebody there, I see your Healer tonight. After his death, now that we look at him, that death will work for you today. And the same redemption that Abel had, you will have it in Jesus' name. You made the sacrifice by faith. You hold on to Christ, our Savior. By faith, you hold on to Christ, our Redeemer. By faith, and your faith will bring that redemption tonight in Jesus' name. Point number two. It's the restorative faith of all others. What does that mean of all others? Have you read Hebrews chapter 11? By faith, Abraham.
Abraham
believed God.
Abraham
counted those things which be not as though they were. There was no child. And yet God promised him. And he said, by this time next year, you'll have a child. It was an impossible situation. Because Abraham was old. And Sarah was old. But he looked not at things that are seen. But he looked at things that were not seen. And by faith, Abraham.
Abraham,
as you have that faith of Abraham, and you count those things which be not as though they were, the miracles would be not as though they were, you will carry miracle home. By faith, Abraham. By faith, Bartimaeus. Bartimaeus was a blind man. He could not see. But he saw people that were going. He heard people that were going. And he said, what's that? What's that? He said, it's Jesus.
When it is
and he's passing by.
What's in record?
What's that tonight?
It's
Jesus.
Only Jesus
is coming your way.
What's
happening tonight? I said it's Jesus.
Money Jesus
is visiting through Larry.
Best
I said it's Jesus.
Only Jesus
is coming to your side there.
And
it began. Bartimaeus began to cry out.
Bartimaeus
thou son of David. Have mercy on me.
Sir, not for me.
And he stopped. Your prayer will stop Jesus tonight.
Your
prayer will arrest the power of Jesus tonight. What do you want me to do unto you? That my eyes may be opened. And he said, receive. And the eyes were opened. Blind man, your eyes will open tonight. Lameness will vanish away tonight.
Abraham,
he got it.
Abraham,
Bartimaeus, he got it.
Bartimaeus.
Have you heard of Caleb?
When
the other people said, we cannot go on. We cannot go to the land of promise. Oh, and Caleb said, we can. With God on our side. Impossibilities will be possible. With God on our side. All those giants against your life. The giants that come in the day. The giants that come in the night. Tonight you will conquer. Tonight you have conquered. By faith, Caleb.
He had
a different spirit. He had a different heart. When he said they cannot, he said I can. Somebody there, I can. Somebody there, I can. I can do all things. Somebody there, I can. I can do all things. Through Christ that strengthens me. By faith, Abraham. By faith, Bartimaeus. By faith, Caleb. By faith, David. Here comes David. Goliath has been troubling everybody. He came out in his full stature.
He
said, I stand as a giant. I stand as a conqueror. If anybody can conquer me, let him come out. Nobody came out. But here comes David. He said, I conquered the lion. I will conquer this one. This one here today, you will conquer this one. This problem in your family, you will conquer this one. This one they call a curse, you will conquer this one. This one they throw arrows at you, this one, you will conquer this one. And so he said, David said, I will conquer him. He had the faith that he will do it. And then they said, Saul said, okay, put this one on. He said, I've never tried this before. What have you tried before? The sling and the stone. The sling and the stone. And so he came. When Goliath saw him, he said, what is this? I'm telling you,
Goliath,
something will happen to you that never happened before.
The
Lord is telling your enemy, invisible enemy, enemies in the night, demonic enemies, something will happen that never happened before. And when he threw that thing, to cut a long story short, Goliath was defeated. And to bring a long story home, Goliath is defeated tonight. By faith, Abraham. By faith, Bartimaeus. By faith, Caleb. By faith, David. By faith, Elijah. Here comes Elijah. And Elijah said, according to my word. There is a word that comes in the mouth of the person that has faith. Elijah said, according to my word, there will be no drop of rain all these years. He had the key in his hand. Faith is a key.
can
lock heaven. Faith is a key. It can open heaven. Faith is a key. It will stop that issue of blood in your body. Faith is a key. And then when eventually, after the years of famine, he came again. And he prayed again. And the rain came. And then you know it was the one that challenged all those occultic people. And he said, the God that answers by fire, let him be that God. And he prayed. And the fire came. The fire will burn everything, every chaff in your life today. The friends of the paralytic.
There
were four of them. The four friends of the paralytic. The man was totally down. And the four friends brought him. And when they could not enter, they went to the room. And then they brought him down in the presence of Jesus. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said, "Son, your sin be forgiven thee." He will forgive your sin today. Every condemnation he'll take away. Every judgment he'll take away. Because he is Jesus. Your sins be forgiven thee. And then he said that ye may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sin. Rise up and walk. And he rose up immediately. And the people said, "We never saw it on this wise." You see, everybody, as they come on, they came by faith. As they rose by faith. As they live their lives, they live by faith. As they pray, they pray by faith. Here comes Gideon.
Gideon
did not know he could win any battle. And then the angel came and said, "A man of valor." Faith puts value in your life. Faith puts value in your life. And then he blew the trumpet. And 32,000 of the Israelites came. God said, "There are too many." And then he took them to the riverside. And eventually only 300 remained. With the 300 people, God said, "You will overcome." Maybe you don't have too many people on your side. Jesus is on your side.
Jesus,
and with Jesus the Savior on your side, Jesus Redeemer on your side,
Jesus,
you have overcome already. I have overcome. I have overcome. I have overcome. And Gideon overcame.
Gideon is his second.
Have you heard of Ezekiah? He was sick. And it was unto death. And as he was sick like that, Isaiah came to him. Isaiah said, "Set your house in order, because you will die, you will not live." Those who are afraid, they don't fear negative prophecy. Those who are facing God, they don't fear anything that a false prophet or even a true prophet says. And so Isaiah dropped the bombshell and went away. And then Ezekiah said, "God, we'll talk about this. Tonight, we'll talk about this." Are you there? I said, "Tonight, we'll talk about this."
He
said, "Lord, remember now, remember your promise. Remember the walking with you."
Not even
bearing. And God said, "All right, you will not die again." Somebody there, you will not die. Premature death is canceled.
I
said, "Isaac, go back and tell the man. I give him 15 years extra."
Extra.
Somebody there extra. You will have it in Jesus' name. Here comes Isaiah himself. Isaiah the man of God. All these other kings, they were rising against the king of Israel, king of Judah. Isaiah said, go tell that king. Those people, those enemies, they will not go back by the same way they came. God will root them out. Every plant the Heavenly Father has not planted in your life, they rooted out tonight. Because the Lord is telling us, it is by faith, from Abraham to Bartimaeus to Caleb and to David, it's by faith. Look at this young man there. His name is Jabez. He was born in sorrow. He was born in suffering. He said, why am I like this? Faith will get you out of every sorrow. Faith will get you out of every problem. Have faith in God. Those tears will dry up. Have faith in God. That tumor will vanish away. Have faith in God. That is knocking your head will vanish away. And as Jabez prayed unto the Lord, he said, oh, that thou will bless me indeed. And that there will be no evil upon my life. And that I will make progress. And God answered all his prayer. Somebody there tonight. I rejoice with you because you are there. Like Jabez, he will answer your prayer in Jesus' name. There was a man in the New Testament. And the Lord had appeared to him. The Lord had told him to go and call Peter. Because Peter was in Joppa. And he said, he will tell you the word whereby you'll be saved. And that man Cornelius, in Acts of the Apostles chapter 10 verse 24, because the king's men together, the king's men of Cornelius. And then eventually Peter came, and Cornelius were the king's men. He said, we're all here to hear whatever it is you want to tell us. And as Peter was speaking, heavens opened. The Holy Ghost came upon them in power. Holy Ghost came upon them with the supernatural. The Holy Ghost will come upon you tonight. All those king's men of Cornelius, they received that power. Now Levi, you remember all the children of Israel, they had fallen, they had failed. And Moses came back from the top of the mountain. God said, I will destroy them. God said, I will not leave any of them alive. Everyone in Israel, from Aaron to the Levites to everybody, they are gone. And then Moses began to pray. God will answer the prayer of Jesus for you. He's making intercession for you. If you think of everything you've done, there'll be no hope. But because of Jesus interceding for you and praying for you, there is hope coming for you tonight. What are you there? God will put a smile and laughter on your face. And then Moses stood by the gate of the camp. And he said, who is on the Lord's side? Let him come unto me. And the Levites look at one another. And he said, there is chance for mercy. There is an open door for grace. There is open door for the love of God. The door of grace is open open for you today. And the door of mercy is open for you today. And the door of the compassion of God is open for you today. And all the sons of Levi came in. For that day, they occupied a special, peculiar position in Israel. I welcome you tonight to a special place in the body of Christ. I welcome you tonight to a peculiar place in the body of Christ. Something is happening to you, you will never forget. Abraham.
Abraham,
Bartimaeus,
Bartimaeu,
Caleb, David,
Davidi,
Elijah, the friends of the paralytic,
Amore, Ocnutonian,
Gideon,
Gideon,
Ezekiah,
Isaiah,
Jabez,
Jabez,
the kinsmen of Cornelius,
Amore, Bato, Corninu,
Levi,
Amore, Levi,
Mary, and Master.
Maria ati Martha.
Lord, if you had been here, our brother Lazarus would not have died. But now we know.
That
even now, whatever you ask the Father, He will do it for you. And I'm telling you tonight, whatever Jesus will ask the Father on your behalf, you've got a miracle tonight. Your blind eyes are open tonight. That part of your life, of your body, is coming alive tonight in Jesus' name. And Jesus said, take away the stone. And Martha said, Lord, the man died about 4 days ago. He's thinking already. And Jesus said, didn't I tell you? If you believe, you will see the glory of God. Somebody there tonight will see the glory of God. And Jesus came to that grave. He said, Lazarus, come forth. And it came forth. You will come forth today. I said, you'll come forth today. Do you remember
Noah?
Because God gave him the word. He said, the flood will come upon all the earth.
And
then he says, by faith, Noah. When God gave him the word, Jesus said, that is what in the days of Noah, so shall it be when the Son of Man shall come. They'll be eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until that blood will come upon them unawares. But the people who are like Noah, you will escape the judgment of God.
Obed-Edom.
It's the ark of God that came to his house. Everybody was afraid. Uzzah died when he touched that thing. I will not allow that act to come to me. They were living in fear. Obed-Edom had faith. He said, let the ark of God come to my house. That represented Jesus Christ. That has the mercy seat. And Jesus is going with you to your house today. And all the time that ark of the covenant was in the house of Obed-Edom. Do you remember that the blessing came? As you take Jesus home today, blessing will come upon your house. Blessing will come upon your family. Here, come look at this woman. Do you know his name, her name? I don't know her name. I call her the quiet petitioner. Quiet petitioner. She didn't talk. She couldn't talk. She couldn't scream. She couldn't tell people, give me chance to get to Jesus. She came from behind. And she said in her heart, a quiet petitioner, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be made whole. Quietly, she touched the hem of the garment of Jesus. 12 years problem vanished away immediately. God bless you. I see you there. I know you are quiet. You've been kind of swallowing your tears. You've been licking your wounds in quiet. What you say tonight is my night. That's true. This is your night. That's true. This is your day. Jesus is here for you. Touch him, he will heal you.
For what can you wear?
Touch him, he will deliver
for
you.
Your
touch him, he will set you free.
For what can you twist?
Look at Ruth.
Worutu.
Ruth came, she was a widow at a young age.
Rutu, o je opo lati oyibo iwe re wa.
The sister-in-law had gone back. Your sister-in-law has gone back. Why don't you also go back? Is there any hope? He said, I have faith. I will go with you. The Lord is calling you. Are you hopeless? Christ is waiting for you here. When you come to the Lord, come out of Moab. Come out of the city of destruction. And come to Jesus. People will be my people. When you leave, I will leave. When you die, I will die. Your God will be my God. And then hope everything turned around. Will turn around for the better in your life in Jesus' name. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I see the three of them coming. Because you cannot separate them. Here is Shadrach. Here is Meshach. Here is
Abednego.
And the king of terror. The king of evil. The king of the furnace, the king of destruction, the great persecutor. He said, I heard. Tell me, is it true? You will not bow down to my idol. If you change your mind, all right. If you say you'll not change your mind, look at that furnace there.
And
somebody threatened you. Occultic powers threatened you. That society threatened you.
As
Nebuchadnezzar threatened you. Tonight you will see the downfall of Satan in your life. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego said, we are not careful to answer you. Do what you want to do. Our God is able. He threw them into the fire. Jesus came there. He's the fourth one. He's the Son of God. And he's the one that came to get them out of that difficulty. And
Nebuchadnezzar
said, didn't we to three people there?
And he said,
and I see four men walking and rise. They have risen up and they are walking. That's
Shadrach.
That's Meshach. That's Abednego. Look at this one. Yes, the fourth one is the appearance of the Son of God. He will be with you in your trouble. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. When you pass through fire, it will not burn you. When you pass through the river, you will not be drowned. Because Jesus Christ is still alive. You know, as I was going through, when I mentioned Noah, and I mentioned Obed-Edom. Peter was waiting for you. I said, you meted my name. And I am here. And Peter said, silver and gold have I not. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And tonight that power will come upon you. Because that name is still mighty and powerful today. That name has never lost its power. Has never lost its authority.
You are listening to our pastor. Pastor W. F. Kumoye, or other anointed minister of God from our ministry. Let the word sink in your heart and they will do you good. throughout your whole life. It is our belief by the grace of the Lord that you will come and worship with us at Deeper Life Bible Church, number 4656 Briarwood Drive. We have our service every Sunday from 9 a.m. to 11:30. And we have our Bible study on every Monday from 7 to 8:30. As you are doing so, the grace of the Lord will continue to be with you, and you will never be the same. Thank you. God bless you.